Hi everyone, this is Talk To Me Tuesday. It's the 19th of May. This is my fourth video, I think, I don't know. It's been a bit of a funny week actually this week. I haven't had a lot of time to sew, which is very unusual. We've been building a summer house in our garden. I say we, my husband's built it with my friends and my brother, but I've been looking after the kids all weekend who have been sick with a cold. So I've been up for the last night was the first night I got any sleep at all, whereas previously I'd been up sort of every hour on the hour dealing with coughing and crying and I don't know, I'm just very tired. And I haven't had a chance to do a lot of crafty. Even my POD block hasn't been done yet this week. I'm going to do it in a minute after I've done the video, because I just haven't had a chance to do anything. So I thought rather than sit here and not make a video or ramble, I'd show you the blocks I've made. Oh, bang the table and the camera shook. The blocks I've made for my Doctor Who quilt and for my Lord of the Rings quilt, which I'm making over the course of this year. So I do a couple of blocks a month in the hopes that at some point I'm gonna get them finished. I'm sorry if I look a mess today. When I went to pick my little boy out from school, the heavens opened. We had thunderstorm, hail and torrential rain, and I didn't have the car, so I got a bit wet and everything looks a bit of a mess. But hey, you're not really interested in what I look like, you're interested in what I've been making, I hope, because otherwise you're going to be very disappointed. Starting with my Doctor Who quilt. I'm sure people will recognise these blocks. I have my little red Dalek. I made a fez, which says it's fez. I wear a fez now, fezzes are cool. I got the quote wrong. I looked it up. I looked up the spelling, and then when I came to put it in my machine, I completely messed it up, but I still like it. The point is there. You don't really want to see Lightning McQueen, who somehow managed to sneak into my Doctor Who blocks. I'll put him over there. It's the crack in space, which has got a little mistake. Just there, you can see. Should be yellow and it's blue. Whoops. I have my TARDIS. My Dalek, love this pattern. It's a pain, but it's well worth it. It's a brilliant aspect of a Dalek. My TARDIS in space. You can't, might not be able to see this one very well. It's K9, but I used a really weird background fabric and the grey doesn't really pop. So I'm probably gonna have to embroider just around him, just to make him pop out just a little bit more, because he's just kind of sinking into the background. And I have a Time Lord. And the block that started it for me was the Weeping Angel block, which I love. It's really quite subtle because I used a real this fabric here to look like stone, but this darker fabric is not as much as the contrast as I would have liked. So again, I think I might have to go in and just embroider a little bit around the fingers and the chin just to make it pop out a little bit more. But there you go. And a Cyberman. Love this pattern. Such good fun. So that's where I am with my Doctor Who quilt. I'm going to be doing River Song's Diary. The Bad Wolf sign, because I love Bad Wolf. Sorry, I keep banging the camera. I really apologise today. I don't quite know what's going on. Yes, so I'm going to do a few more blocks for it, and then I'll put it all together. And that one will be done. My Lord of the Rings quilt so far, she says. I have Gimli's axe. Legolas's bow. Again, you might not be able to see this one very well because it's really, fabrics are really weird. It's this background fabric. It's just really, really hard to see anything. But this is the Crest of Rohan, I think. That's what it's called. This one, thank you, Jennifer, was a right pain in the backside. It's a brilliant pattern. but the pieces and the lining up. But I did it and I was happy with it. This is my schmog. This is the road. Again, this fabric just seems to throw any block I do. It's really, really odd. But have I got that the wrong way? It's also because I was holding it the wrong way up, which doesn't really help. This is the road and the mountain in the background. That's from the Hobbit block. Someone's eye with a thread coming out of him. This was my initial attempt at Helm's Deep, which I quite like, but I kind of want to make this one again with one fabric for the buildings or one colour wave of fabric for the building, so either some browns or some greys, because I think the fact I've switched between greys, browns, blacks, it just kind of doesn't look like what it's supposed to look like. But that was my issue, not the pattern. Tolkien symbol. Arwen's necklacey life force, whatever it is, thing. I have read the books and seen the films, I promise. This is my one of my favourites. This is the Black Gates of Gondor, which I love. I also have the tower, which, and if I just turn you around, I'm sorry if I'm making you feel sick. That's all right. There's my tower, and there's my what makes up for my project wall. I did that one last year. It's one of the first paper pieces I did, and yeah, that's, I love that one. That's why it's on the wall. Yeah. So aside from that, I haven't really done anything crafty. Banging the camera again. Trying to think what else. I don't know if, well, those of you who are Tolkien fans will know that Oxford is where Tolkien wrote Lord of the Rings, and spent a lot of time in a pub up here called the Eagle and Child's. And before we had kids, we went to that pub quite often. It's quite a famous, you must go here when you come to Oxford kind of thing. So we went there quite often for drinks and stuff, and so I need to try and get a postcard to send to Jennifer, if you're out there, which I'm sure you will be, because it's where Tolkien and his friends debated life, the meaning, the universe and everything else. So I need to get you that postcard and get it sent to you, because yeah, you're a Tolkien fan, you can add it to your collection. And the only other thing I've got to show you is my husband, who I've mentioned briefly that he works on a contract for the BBC. He had a tour of the BBC studios last week, and when he came back, he'd been to the BBC shop and he had bought me this is a TARDIS money box. It's very cool. My husband knows me so well. Most women, flowers, roses, chocolates, I do like chocolates, perfume, me, a TARDIS money box. And on that very sad note, I will leave you. Have a lovely week. Hope your crafting goes well. Hopefully I'll have more to show you next week. Bye.